without reproductive health. And reproductive health includes contraception and family planning and access to legal, safe abortions. According to Clinton, and this was in his talk only in March 20, 2010 in Ottawa, Canada. Some people, sabi ng mga RH, pag meron daw mga contraceptives, pag meron mga condom, parati nilang siya side. Many countries, including Thailand, mababawasan daw ang abortion. But look what happened only a few weeks ago. Thailand police find 2,000 fetuses in temple in Thailand. Dito meron isa, meron dalawa, may tatlong fetus, ginagawang malaking issue. But in Thailand, which is the one of the poster boys of the RH initiative, 2,000 fetuses found in one temple. Yan yung mga litrato ng mga fetuses. Sinasabi rin nila na pagdating sa populasyon, pag mataas daw ang population density, maghihirap ang bansa. Of course, we all know that when it comes to determining the effect of population, it is not just the absolute number of people in a country, but the population density, which is very important. This is the number of persons per square kilometer. The Philippines has a population density of 266. If you look at the countries that have a higher population density, even much higher, you will find out that there are countries like Macau, Monaco, 20,000 as against 266, 16,000 for Monaco, 6,571 for Hong Kong, Singapore, 5,000 is going to be elaborated upon by Dr. Villegas later. Most of these countries, Taiwan, Korea, have population densities much higher than the population density of the Philippines, but they are much more developed. In other words, there was no effect on them. In fact, it's even the reverse, that even more progressive than the Philippines. But look at the other countries that have a smaller population density. These are countries like Mongolia, French Guiana, Namibia, Botswana, Suriname, Mauritania, Chad, Central African Republic, countries which have a much lower population density, but which are much, much poorer than the Philippines. In other words, the reverse is the one being indicated by a lower population density. Now, this is the comparison of the top 10 countries by population density, and it can be seen, it's very obvious, that most of them, almost 90% of them, are much, much more developed and more progressive than the Philippines. And this would include Korea and Taiwan, which was in the same league as the Philippines about 40 years ago. But in spite of the very high population density, they have developed by leaps and bounds compared to the Philippines. Now, these are the countries with a population density much lower than the Philippines, but look at where they are now. Except for Australia, most of them are very poor countries like Botswana, French Guiana, Mongolia, Western Sahara, etc., etc., and much more. And even here in the Philippines, if we rank the places, cities and provinces by population density, you will note that it is also the provinces and the cities that have a much higher population density, that have a much higher per capita income as well. It is those provinces that have a very low population density that are the relatively more hard up countries, hard up provinces and cities like these provinces that I have on the chart, with a population density of only 24, 49, 51, 53, 54, compared to the average population density of 266. And if we rank it by per capita income from the highest to the lowest, you will also note that it is the cities and the provinces that have the highest population density that also have the highest per capita income. And of course, San Juan is number two as far as per capita income is concerned. Congratulations po sa Congressman San Juan. I'd like to invite you to read Nanda Nilekani. He wrote a best-selling book. As you know, India is more closely associated with a very populous country, and a lot of people think that population is supposed to be a negative factor as far as the growth of a country is concerned. But Nanda Nilekani, a billionaire, according to Forbes, one of the wealthiest in the world. He's now going around the world, visiting London, New York, Washington DC, delivering lectures, and according to him, speaking at the London School of Economics on April 22, Mr. Nilekani said, that one idea, by the way, India is a model for development today, one idea which has contributed to India's economic rise is human capital. India, according to the Likani, no longer views its large population as a liability, but as an asset. This is, of course, backed up by another famous author, George Friedman, author and founder of Strathmore. He came out with an international best-selling book, The Next 100 Years, where he is forecasting what's going to happen to the world in the next 100 years, and he is stating that there will be some countries that are going to suffer because of population shrinkage, because of the population control. According to him, today, developed countries see the problem as keeping immigrants out. Later in the first half of the 21st century, and that will be a few years from now, the problem will be persuading them to come. Countries will go so far as to pay people to move there, because otherwise they will have to compete for increasingly scarce immigrants and will be doing everything it can to induce Mexicans, Filipinos to come to the United States because of the shrinking population in those areas. The same thing is going to happen not only in the United States, but also in Canada and many countries in Western Europe, including Korea and Japan. Low fertility rate in Asia. South Korea is spending billions of dollars to boost their birth rate. They have allocated $67 billion for the next 5 years in order to boost their birth rate, because now they're feeling the pinch because of population decline. Would you believe that today they have only half of the elementary school students compared to how it was in 1970 or 40 years ago? So many of their villages are starting to die in South Korea. Population decrease to stunt Korea. This is according to Goldman Sachs Asset Management, a very respected investment banking company. And according to them, Korea is going to fall behind in the next coming years to countries like Indonesia, the Philippines, and even Nigeria. And the reason for that is because of their population decline. German birth rate falls to post-war record low. Aging population. Because of aging population, China is now rethinking their 30-year-old one-child policy. This is in USA Today, in Washington Post, looming population crisis forces China to revisit one-child policy. Hungarian population is worried about extinction. Former President Bill Clinton came to the Philippines November 11, 2010, delivered a speech at the Manila Hotel. A lot of the RH people were thinking that he was going to speak something in favor of RH, but he said, and I quote, "You have a youth population, which is a positive." But to counter this, the pro-RH people quoted Secretary Clinton, Hillary Clinton, but of course, as we all know, Hillary Clinton is an exponent of legal abortion. This is probably one of the most interesting sonas delivered in the world. Russian President Dmitry Medvedev, he spent almost half of his sona, his State of the Russia speech, where he asked Russian couples to have a third child or more. And he is now offering a baby bonus